Good morning and welcome to Christ Church Anglican. I'm Father Matt Traylor, and we are so pleased that you have come to worship the Lord Jesus with us this morning. If you're visiting with us, you receive one of these bulletins, and what you mainly need to know is that the words in bold are the words that we all say together, and all the other instructions are in there, but you can kind of look around and see what everybody else is doing, and you'll fit in just fine. If this is your first time visiting us, again, we're just so glad that you're here. Please stick around for coffee hour and Sunday school afterwards, as we would love to get to know you. Please rise as we begin worship this morning.
To our King.
God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ says. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people. Christ, only
Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you are always more ready to hear than we to pray, and to give more than we either desire or deserve. Pour down upon us the abundance of your mercy, forgiving us those things of which our conscience is afraid, and giving us those good things for which we are not worthy to ask, except through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated for the reading of Holy Scripture.
Today's reading will be from 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 1 through 15, page 307 in your pew Bible. Now when the Lord was about to take up Elijah to the heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. And Elijah said to Elisha, "Please stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. And the sons of the prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take away your master from over you?" And he said, "Yes, I know it. Keep quiet." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, please stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. The sons of the prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take away your master from over you?" And he said, "Yes, I know it. Keep quiet." Then Elijah said to him, "Please stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the sons of the prophets also went and stood at some distance from them, as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his cloak, rolled it up, and struck the water. And the water was parted to the one side and to the other, till the two of them could go over on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Ask what I shall do for you before I am taken from you." And Elisha said, "Please let there be a double portion of your spirit on me." And he said, "You have asked for a hard thing. Yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it shall be so for you. But if you do not see me, it shall not be so." And as they still went on and talked, behold, chariots of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven. And Elisha saw it, and he cried, my father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." And he saw them no more. Then he took hold of his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. And he took up the cloak of Elijah that had fallen from him and went back and stood on the bank of the Jordan. Then he took the cloak of Elijah that had fallen from him and struck the water, saying, "Where is the Lord, the God of Elijah?" And when he had struck the water was parted to the one side and to the other, and Elisha went over. Now when the sons of the prophets who were at Jericho saw him opposite them, they said, "The spirit of Elijah rests on Elisha." And they came to meet him and bowed to the ground before him. The word of the Lord. Today's psalm is Psalm 114. We will pray responsibly by the half verse. When Israel came out of Egypt, and the house of Jacob from among a people of a foreign tongue, the sea beheld it and fled. The mountains skipped like rams. What ailed you, O sea, that you fled? O Jordan, that you were driven back? Tremble, O earth, at the presence of the Lord, at the presence of the God of Jacob.
Reading from St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians. To me, though I am the very least of all the saints, this grace was given to preach to the Gentiles the unsearchable riches of Christ, and to bring to light for everyone what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God, who created all things, so that through the church the manifold wisdom of God might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was according to the eternal purpose that he has realized in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have boldness and access with confidence through our faith in him. So I ask you not to lose heart over what I am suffering for you, which is your glory. For this reason I bow my knees before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that according to the riches of his glory, he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit in your inner being, so that Christ may dwell in your heart, in your hearts through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may have strength to comprehend with all the saints what is the breadth and length and height and depth, and to know the love of Christ that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think, according to the power at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Immediately, Jesus made his disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side, to Bethsaida, while he dismissed the crowd. And after he had taken leave of them, he went up on the mountain and to pray. And when evening came, and the boat was out on the sea, and he was alone on the land, and he saw that they were making headway painfully, for the wind was against them. And about the fourth watch for the night, he came to them walking on the sea. He meant to pass them by. But when they saw him walking on the sea, they thought it was a ghost and cried out, for they all saw him and were terrified. But immediately he spoke to them and said, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." And he got into the boat with them, and the wind ceased. And they were utterly astounded, for they did not understand about the loaves, but their hearts were hardened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ. heavens in Christ, grace and peace to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. Amen. Please be seated. The gospel lesson today that you just heard is about Jesus walking on the water. And this story takes place in the Gospels immediately after the feeding of the 5,000. Remember, the disciples gathered 5 loaves and 2 fishes, and they gave them to Jesus. And then Jesus prayed, and he gave them to the disciples. And the disciples began to distribute the 5 loaves and 2 fishes and distribute the 5 loaves and 2 fishes and distribute the 5 loaves and 2 fishes until the 5,000 were fully fed and satisfied, the scripture says. And there were 12 baskets of leftovers. 12 baskets, it says. Probably one for each of the disciples, right? Now, you would think that the disciples would start to get an idea through this about who Jesus is, right? I mean, who does this anyway? Who can feed a crowd with 5 loaves and 2 fish? Who could do that? I mean, even more than that, who can create fish, right? And create them with just a word from his mouth. The disciples saw this. They saw the crowd. They had handled the loaves and fishes. They were part of the miracle. And after this, Jesus sends the disciples ahead of him to the other side of the lake in a boat while he went up to pray. Somewhere between 3 and 6 in the morning, scripture says, the disciples were a long way from the shore. So in case you think Jesus was just waiting in the shallows, he wasn't. They were out in the middle of the lake, and the lake at that time was probably somewhere about 150 feet deep. So a storm came up while the disciples were in the boat, and the wind was against them, and it says, in Matthew's gospel, it says that they were beaten by the waves. In other words, this was a big storm, and the disciples were in trouble. Jesus saw them from the place where he was praying, out on the lake, struggling against the wind. So he came to them in an unusual way, right? He came to them walking on the water. And when they first saw Jesus on the water, scripture says they were terrified. They were terrified. Then Jesus spoke these words to them, these comforting words. Take heart, it is I. Jesus got in the boat with them, and the wind ceased, the storm calmed. And Mark writes that the disciples were utterly astounded by all of this because they didn't understand about the loaves and the fishes. He's still connecting it to what just happened before. They didn't get what was going on with the loaves of the fishes. They didn't understand who Jesus is yet. They didn't understand that their leader, their Lord, was God incarnate, God in the flesh. Their master is the creator. He created the loaves and fish to feed the crowd. The Lord of heaven and earth alone can calm a storm and the wind with the word from his mouth. Take heart, it is I, he says. This phrase that he utters, it is I, is a familiar phrase, one that the disciples might remember because literally translated in the Greek says, ego Eimi, ego eimi, which means I am. I am. The same words that he uses when he says, I am the good shepherd. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but by me. I am the God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I am, was with them in the boat. Shift gears now a little bit to that great theologian, Bum Phillips. Y'all know who Bum Phillips is? He was the coach of the Houston Oilers at one time. He said, back then, he said, there's only two kinds of NFL coaches, those that have been fired and those that are going to be fired. Now, in Christianity, there's really only two kinds of Christians, those who are in a storm and those who are going to be in a storm, because storms happen, right? To borrow and paraphrase the phrase from the 60s, right? Storms happen. And they come to all of us. They come to us even when we're following Jesus. Storms happen. Christians aren't exempt from the storms. So don't believe people who tell you, if your faith was big enough, you wouldn't be in a storm. Because storms happen, the disciples were following Jesus. And they went right into a storm, didn't they? We know this. The important thing here is to know that when a storm hits, don't forget who's in the boat with you. Don't forget. In John 16:33, Jesus said, in this world, you will have tribulation. What is a tribulation? It's a storm, right? You're going to have storms. But take heart, I've overcome the world, he says. Take heart. The same thing he told the disciples when they were afraid. Take heart. Be encouraged. Have courage. Trust me. That's what he's saying. He spoke this to the fearful disciples. Take heart. I'm going to be bold here and ask for a show of hands. Who among you here this morning have been in a storm at some point in your life? Look around, everybody. Keep your hands up for a second. Look around. Look around. Okay. And again, a show of hands. How many of you have experienced Jesus in your storm? Amen. Look around again. This is encouraging. It's encouraging to me. And for those of you who are in a storm this morning, be encouraged. Take heart. Jesus says, I see you there in that storm, and I am with you. In my almost 70 years of life, be 70 in November, I've seen some storms myself. And in my almost 30 years of teaching and preaching, you probably heard about most of my storms by now. Probably more than once. So I'm not going to go into detail about my storms this morning, because my storms aren't that important anymore. What's important is who's in the storms with us. We'll focus on him. I'm going to tell you this, though. There are many different kinds of storms out there. A great variety of storms. There are storms of health, storms in your relationships, career storms, financial storms, storms with our kids and our grandkids. There's even storms in our churches. Some storms are self-inflicted, aren't they? We bring them on ourselves, some of them. These are the ones that come as a result of some sin, excuse me, or a bad choice, or hurtful words or actions. Some storms are just a result of life. Sometimes you're walking along, maybe even following Jesus closely, and a storm just jumps right up and bites you. It'll do it. Life happens sometimes, right? Life happens. But if you're a child of God through faith in Jesus, if you've received Jesus as your Savior, when a storm comes, whatever the cause, whether it just happens or it's self-inflicted, still, don't forget who's in the boat with you. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords is with you. The same Lord who multiplied the loaves and fishes, who calmed the wind and the sea, who spoke the words into existence with just the world into existence, rather, with just a word of his mouth, who died for you, who rose from the dead. Jesus, the Son of God, is with you, and he's in you. He's in you. That's who's in your boat. Jesus is with you. So cry out to him in a storm, because he's there and he cares. Sometimes he comes and he calms the wind and the sea in a miracle. Sometimes he comes and he just calms the sailor in the boat and sees them through to the other side. But he will always come. He'll always come. He'll come in your storm because he promised he would. And Jesus keeps his promises, doesn't he? He's good to his word because he is the word. He says this, I am with you always. He says, I will never forsake you. I will never abandon you. He says this, nothing, not even death, can separate you from me. Because I'm with you and I'm in you. In their storms, the disciples struggled because they didn't fully yet understand who Jesus was. They didn't understand yet about the loaves and fishes, the scripture said. But in later years, they remembered. They remembered, right? They remembered the miracles. They remembered the woman with the issue of blood who touched the hem of Jesus' garment and was healed. They remembered the tomb of Lazarus and what happened there. They remembered Jairus' daughter. They remembered the nails. They remembered the cross. And they remembered the open tomb. They remembered. They remembered. And they wrote it all down for us, right? So that we would remember. They wrote it down so that in our own storms, thousands of years later, we would still know who's in the boat with us. And we would take heart, just like they did. This week, I encourage you to look back on the storms of your life, the storms that you've been through. And as you do, also think about how Jesus came to you in the storm. He comes in different ways. Sometimes they're unusual, like walking on the water. But he comes by faith. You know this. You've experienced him. You know that he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You know that. You know that he's there with you and in the boat with you. He promised it. You've experienced him in his saving word, his saving hand. As he was, he is, and always will be. And as you remember this week, take heart. Take heart. And if you're in a storm, take heart and be encouraged. And know that storms come in this life, and they'll keep coming. But you don't have to be afraid, because when they do come, take heart and always remember that Jesus is in your boat. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Thank you, Chaplain Skip. Please rise and let us confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit in the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the church and for the world, saying, hear our prayer. For the peace of the whole world and for the well-being and unity of the people of God. Lord, in your mercy. For Steve, our archbishop, and Ryan, our bishop, and for all the clergy and people of our diocese and congregation. Lord, in your mercy. For all those who proclaim the gospel at home and abroad, and for all who teach and disciple others. Lord, in your mercy. For our brothers and sisters in Christ who are persecuted for their faith. Lord, in your mercy. For our nation, for those in authority, and for all in public service, especially Joseph, our president, Greg, our governor, Lori, our mayor, and Terry, our county judge. Lord, in your mercy. For all those who are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, especially the Pendergrass family, Father Bill Tapley, Nash Cantwell, Holly Chandler, Kathy Leggett, and Ed Williams. Lord, in your mercy. For all those who have departed this life in the certain hope of the resurrection, especially Father Henry Pendergrass, in thanksgiving, let us pray. Lord, in your mercy.
Heavenly Father, grant these our prayers for the sake of Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who in his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who sincerely repent and with true faith turn to him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. Please rise. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Pat Denham, Jared Oakes, John Holmes, Ian Wilkes, Madison Rose, and Nelson Spear. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face upon you and give you peace. Amen. And our anniversaries this week are Lee and Debbie Scarborough, Rowdy and Michelle Stillwell, and Mitch and Sherry Maloof. May you continue to find joy in each other's company. May your home be filled with love and peace. And may you always find comfort in each other's arms. Amen.
Good morning, Christ Church family. If you're new with us this morning, welcome. We are so glad to have you here with us. And we'd love the opportunity to get to know you better. So we would encourage you, if you would, fill out a welcome card, which you can find in the back of the pew in front of you. Fill it out and place it in the offering plate as it goes by. We have quite a bit of announcements this morning, so bear with me, because we had a slight hiccup with our printing with Microsoft Word. And so the wrong version was printed on the back. So I'm going to give you the correct information, and we will also be posting the correct version on social media and also emailing that out, so you won't miss anything. First and foremost, next weekend is going to be our last combined service before we return to two services. So August 11th, we will have our 8:30 and our 10:45 service with Sunday school in between at 9:45. We have a normal week of Bible studies except for no adult study on Wednesday night. This afternoon is the gun show, and we'd encourage y'all to join Nelson Spear and the rest of the prayer team at the Horseshoe Arena to pray, pass out Bibles, share the gospel. That does end at 5, so come for as long as you want. We do have the back to school block party this Wednesday from 6 to 7:30. Lots of fun in store with jumpers, food trucks. The Midland Police Department and the Fire Department will bring their trucks out. So we'd love for y'all to join us, help us pass out school supplies, which we are going to extend that due date for school supply donations because we would love some more. That way we can bless many kids that are in need of school supplies. So if you can get us those by Wednesday, we will take them. Popsicles in the Park is going to be this Friday from 10 to 11:15, meeting at Essex Park. And young adults and your families are invited to join us this Saturday, August 3rd, from 2 to 5. We are going to have a cookout and pool party hosted by the Resnicks. And so bring a snack to share and a towel if you plan to swim. If you need any more information, you can contact Michelle Stillwell. The healing prayer service is next Sunday, August 4th at 6:30 with Diane Ray as speaker. And there will be a training coming up in September, which the lovely Tricia and Kip will have more on that for you next week.
All right. Good morning. So for those of you who don't know, we just got back from a splashway trip with all of the youth. Splashway is a campground, water park kind of combination in Sheridan, Texas, about 2 hours east of San Antonio. In total, we had 23 people go. We had four amazing leaders, and then me. We had John and Diane Utzman. We had Jane Oakes, and then my lovely wife, Megan, also was there to help. We had 16 youth kids, 16 incredible youth. One blessing we had just off the get-go, we had the Teen Challenge lent us their 15-passenger van. So we were able to party out with the kids' playlist for 7.5 hours straight. As we planned to go, the forecast showed rain every single day, which is not typically good news for a water park adventure. But as he does, God had a plan. And not only was there no rain on Thursday, which was our day for the water park, but it also, the threat of rain kept away most of the crowds. So we rode ride after ride after ride after ride after ride. And I think everyone got to ride basically everything they wanted. We waited in no more than 10-minute lines, and it ended up being a fantastic experience. We also got to have a great night discussion around a campfire that night. Again, no rain. One of the most amazing parts, we saw multiple acts of kindness from our youth. Specifically, on two separate occasions, I saw Sawyer, Thomas, and Amanda both just help a couple kids who were struggling to get their rafts up the four flights of stairs. With no nudge, they just went up, asked if they could help, and carried it up for them. And I just wanted, that's just a couple examples of the type of kids that we have in this youth group. So, however, now that we are back, the youth will be in need of some financial support, prayer support. We appreciate all the contributions we've received thus far, and as we move into the fall, we're going to have lots of fundraising opportunities that the kids are going to work on. Because of your generosity through our car wash last month, all the kids that went to the car wash and participated had the entire way paid for. So no one had to pay other than a couple who weren't able to make it to the car wash. So thank you again to all the parents just for letting us take your kids 8 hours away for a couple days. I know that can be scary, but it was just so much fun, and we just appreciate the great group of young people that we have. So thank you.
Sorry, I kind of feel like the Ferris Bueller teacher that then Bueller. I kept following them. I'm kind of sorry. But got a couple of more announcements just want to pass on. First is this. We are so fortunate. We have kind of done searches, and we've looked for youth ministers, and we find them right here in our own body. So Todd and Megan, this spring, started having conversations with me, with Father Henry, and through that we said, hey, let's go through the summer, but we want you to be the people. We've watched them minister to kids, so they followed up Brian, who did such a great job of building the group of kids, and so now we have this next team that is taking over. These are our youth ministers for Christ Church. They will be in place moving forward full time. So we are really excited. You can tell by just organization and things that have happened. It's been a really good summer, and we're grateful for all of you that have supported them, supported Brian, the youth. This has been a great gift to us. Next, there are a couple of things that I want to pass on that are important, and this comes following Father Henry. One of the things that we've talked about a lot this year was first that we are going to be with Jesus. We want to be like Jesus and do what Jesus did. And so with that, much of that was focused on mission. As Father Henry started talking in the fall, one of the things he said, we've just completed this amazing project, but that we're not finished. Our next real project is to begin to have impact in the world and unreach people here in Midland, around the United States, around the world. And what if we had the same focus that we had on building this building? Over the next 10 years, what would it look like if we started supporting missions that we're able to reach the world around us, but around the world, the nations, with the people of Christ Church? We will be establishing, and you'll hear more about it. The fund's already set up, but you'll hear more information in the coming weeks. We are establishing the Colleen and Father Henry Visions for Mission Fund. It will be something that we can all be a part of, that we can give to. It really, really is the heart of, was Father Henry's heart, but also the heart of this place to reach the world for Jesus Christ. And so this fund will be established, You will hear more stuff will come out if you would like to be a part of that. But I just wanted to at least let you know and plant the seed that this is coming. We also know that we are talking to the bishop. We have conversations this week. Everything is in motion. We are having conversations that we need to as we transition during this time. One of the things, though, as we talk about missions going back, that's really, really important to us is that we want to make sure that anyone who goes on a mission trip, that we send them as a body, that we pray for them, and that we give people opportunity to share when they come back. So with that, we have Robin Wilson, who is, come on over, Robin. Robin, her husband Tom, works for East-West Ministries. They have take trips all over. They've been a part of this. In fact, Robin is filling in. Robin is going to Bolivia, and this leaves on Thursday, the 1st. This is one of these great things that we do. We know from our relationship with Father Walter, Bolivia is in great need of the gospel. And so Robin will be going with a team to Bolivia this week through August the 9th. I would ask you to pray for her. And I'm going to pray for her now, but if you want to reach out where you are or do whatever, please join us as we pray. Father God, thank you so much for this dear friend and all that you have called her to. Father, just she has, since I've known her, have gone to the places where Jesus needs to be proclaimed. Father, I pray that you would go with Robin as she embarks on this trip with this team. Father, give them and place a hedge of protection around them. Father, that your Holy Spirit would go before them, beside them, behind them, and lead them always. Father, that there would be many, many that would come to call your name, and that they would call you Savior. Father, we thank you for your son, Jesus, and it's in your name that we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Drip. As we come to the altar this morning, you'll see, if you're visiting with us, the instructions there. Anyone who's baptized and can receive communion in your own church is welcome to receive with us here this morning. As you come to Lord Jesus, as you offer him yourself this week in our Eucharistic prayer and our offerings, that was so good, Chaplain Skip. What's the storm that you're praying for, praying about this morning in your own life? Jesus is in your boat. Are you asking Jesus to do a miracle in the storm that's going on, to change the circumstance? Or are you asking Jesus to calm the sailor, to calm you in the midst of the storm? So you know what Jesus is saying to you this morning, and as you come to him, bring those things to him. Now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God.
Jesus calls us with a tumult of our lives while restlessly, day by day his clear voice soundeth, saying, Christian, follow me. As of old Saint Andrew's heard it by the Galilean lake, turn from home and toil and kindred, leaving all for his dear sake. Jesus calls us from the worship of the vain world's golden store, from each idol that would keep us, saying, Christian, love me more. In our joys and in our sorrows, days of toil and hours of ease, still he calls in cares and pleasures, Christian, love me more than these. Jesus calls us by thy mercy, Savior, may
Things come from you, O Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had sinned against you and become subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, into the world for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, he became flesh and dwelt among us. In obedience to your will, he stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself once for all, that by his suffering and death we might be saved. By his resurrection, he broke the bonds of death, trampling hell and Satan under his feet. As our great high priest, he ascended to your right hand in glory, that we might come with confidence before the throne of grace. On the night that he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, and we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your word and Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Sanctify us also, that we may worthily receive this holy sacrament and be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ and bring us with all your saints into the joy of your heavenly kingdom, where we shall see our Lord face to face. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen, amen, amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. We do not presume to come to this your table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your abundant and great mercies. Apart from your grace, we are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table. But you are the same, Lord, whose character is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Amen. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. Amen. Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you
send you out this week to share communion with Mary Faye Wallace. May you carry the prayers of all of us as you take this sacrament of Christ's presence. May those who receive it from you be strengthened and encouraged in that community we have together in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Thank you, guys.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Lord, the light of your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us. Set us free by the truth you will bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Raise spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let men be light. Yes, we gaze at your keenly brightness, so our face is displayed.
Peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.